Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Michael McIntyre.
Huge year, of course, ladies and gentlemen, we're involved in 2012. Doesn't get more exciting than this. Got the Olympics. The Queen, it's her year. 60 years on the throne, Her Majesty. I love the Queen. You've got to love the Queen. She's super cool. She's on money. You can't get much cooler than being on money. That's her in the corner. You've seen her, that one.
Hello. I'm up here. I'm on all money.
But it's always the same image of the Queen. It doesn't matter how much money you've got. I always thought they missed a trick with this. I always thought there should be more exciting images of the Queen, depending on the denomination of money. £50 Queen, she should be there in all her glory. Big velvet robes, crown jewels. I'm £50 Queen. I'm the Queen of all England. 1p Queen, she should have a dressing gown on, rollers, chocolate hair, cigarettes on the go.
I'm 1p Queen. Wanna see the real me? Earn some bloody money.
But you've got to love the royal family. I just love seeing people who live their lives in no way like we do. You saw this at the wedding last year when William married Kate. Prince Charles took his sword. Who takes a sword to a family wedding? You saw him walking down the aisle with his sword. We never knew when it could kick off, I suppose. You've got to be tense when your father-in-law comes armed, all right? You fucking treat him good, all right? Did he expect some terrorist to break through all the security and run down the aisle? Don't worry, I've got this covered. Come on, you fucker. Did Prince Philip have a bow and arrow? Cover me. Did the Queen have nunchucks in her socks?
Nobody messes with Willie's day.
I actually met the Queen. I don't mean to show off, but it was fun. I got invited last year. In one of the most exciting post days of my entire life, I got an invitation to Buckingham Palace. You know, post is basically boring. Every morning, the post goes, bills and previous owner posts, rubbish. But this was, even as I was coming down the stairs, I could see something glowing in the post. What is that? I sort of swept away the other junk. It was quite heavy as I picked it up. It seemed to have silk woven into the card. My name was written in calligraphy. It must have taken them half an hour just to write the N. I turned it round, there was a seal on it. A red wax seal. I was like, oh, I'm going to Hogwarts. I was so excited. I knew I was a wizard. I need an owl, a wand. I need to book a taxi to King's Cross. There's so much to do. I opened it up. Classic. It said, Dear Michael, the master of the household, very exciting, would like to invite you to Buckingham Palace to meet Her Majesty the Queen of England on this date. RSVP, masterofthehousehold@buckinghampalace.com. Email. And I was like, I can't believe it, I'm going to Buckingham Palace. I did think it was a one-on-one at first. I didn't realise it was like hundreds of people. I thought she'd see me on the telly. I like him, bring him round. We watched Downton together. So I immediately email back, Dear Master of the Household, yes please, I would like to come and meet the Queen. Michael. Then I signed it, Master of My Household. Now as soon as I sent it, I regretted it. Why have I tried to be funny with a faceless Master of Buckingham Palace? That's not, he's not gonna get a laugh. He's not gonna email me back, LOL, that's not gonna happen. What do I expect to happen? He's going to wake up the Queen. Wake up, Your Majesty. The most hilarious email has just come through. Get me my glasses. Philip, check this out. Oh, I love that Chinese man. That wasn't going to happen. What are the chances? So I show up at Buckingham Palace, and lots of people are arriving, and there's this man greeting us. I presume he's the master of the household. And everyone's asking the same thing. What do you call her? What do you call the Queen? What do you say to her? What do you call her? What do you do? How do you bow? People are queuing up with the same question. How do you curtsy? And And he said, you must call her ma'am, like jam. I hoped he'd said that to everyone. I hope he didn't look at me and think, he'll need a rhyming word, this idiot. He said, you must call her ma'am like jam, not mom. He said it really dismissively, not mom. Like something awful would happen if I called her, like she'd hit me with a handbag. How dare you? How disappointing after your hilarious email. Prince Philip walking behind, you've disgraced the whole of China. So everyone goes into this room. And there were famous people there as well. Kevin Spacey was there. Duffy, the Welsh singer. Helen Mirren was there. But no one had a plus one. Everyone was on their own. And everyone was rehearsing. It was the weirdest scene I've ever seen. We're all in this huge big room with big curtains and paintings. And everyone's just going, Kevin Spacey, ma'am, ma'am like jam. Ma'am, ma'am like jam, ma'am like jam. Duffy's going, mom like jam, it's mom, mom like jam, mom like jam. Terrible tension in the room. And then somebody comes in and says, everybody just please line up for Her Majesty, please. So we all line up. No one's speaking like this. Kevin Spacey, Duffy. Helen Mirren. Huge doors open, very dramatically as well. Like this man steps aside. I think it was fanfare as well. That's what the Queen has. How cool is that? She walks into it, doors open, and people go, amazing. The closest we get to that is when we walk into the co-op, and it goes, doo-doo, that's as close as we get. The Queen. And I think it was because everything was so big, the ceiling was so high, the door was so big, that she actually looked quite funny, because she's quite tiny, she sort of comes in like this. Wearing white gloves, I assume she'd been refereeing a snooker match next door or something. And Prince Philip came in backwards. He had no idea where he was. He sort of stumbled in. With the longest eyebrows I've ever seen on a human being. And no one said a word. Everyone's just lined up. And one by one, she meets people. But she doesn't know who they are, because she's the Queen. She doesn't have to. She has a man. A man stands behind her and says, identifies people. He goes, Kevin Spacey, American actor. And she goes, yeah. How cool is that, though, having someone remind you? Because you've all been in that situation when someone's just chatting away in your face, and you have no idea who they are. You're not really listening, you're just going, who the fuck are you? It's so convenient to have someone in your ear just going, your wife. Thank you. I knew I'd recognize you, darling. How are you? How was your day? So within moments, she's in front of me. The Queen. The actual Queen in her suit with her gloves and her hair. From the one from Money and Stamps and the song, God Save Her. The Queen of 60 years is in my face, the monarch! And I just went, jam. And that was it. She goes to the next person, that's all I said to her. My moment with the Queen, and they bought off a small part of breakfast. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for listening to me. You're here for a very good cause. Goodbye. Thank you. Bye!